subject is alternative fuel and power system in automobile branch. Today we discussion about chapter number 9, non-conventional IC engine. And today we discussion about the topic is, first is, previous lecture I can explain this non-conventional IC engine. The topic is, so what is a non-conventional IC engine? The best example of vehicle and rotary engine, what is the construction and working of vehicle and rotary engine and free piston engine. The next topic, the non-conventional IC engine. Today we discussion about the topic is Stirling engine and the VCR, this variable compression ratio engine. Let we start. First we discussion about Stirling engine. Okay, so first you can see the diagram of Stirling engine. Means, okay, so you can see the diagram. Means external heat means the fueling. The external heat is source. Okay, Stirling engine is a types of IC engine which, unlike this internal combustion engine, the heat energy source is external that can be achieved by various means, like it can be achieved by this burn the fuel, or it can be done by electrical means depending on the efficiency required. It is a known as Stirling engine. You can see the diagram is the external heat is source is pulling means the compression expansion of this gas. And the is there is a two source, external and internal, means hot source and cold source. Okay, you can see the diagram of this basic definition of this Stirling engine, how it is work. Then second is, what is the working of Stirling engine? You can see the diagram of this, how it is working of Stirling engine, this working of principle. The Stirling engine is used as a two closed chamber. One is heat source and other is cooling source. Means inside this gas is enclosed. The compression and expansion of this interlinked piston, this both this cylinder is possessed by this cold and hot gases, which is not provide this mechanical output through the connected the crankshaft. It is a work of Stirling engine. Means there is a two closed chamber. First is heat and cooling source. Means heat source and external heat source. Means the gas is compressed and expansion of this burn this gas. And this cooling, the gas is cooling this system and the leaf for another cycle. Means to connect it this crankshaft. It is a work of Stirling engine. Then next point is Stirling engine. The types of Stirling engine means there is a two types of Stirling engine. First is alpha Stirling engine, second is beta Stirling engine. You can see the diagram of this. First is alpha Stirling engine, how it is work, and this beta Stirling engine means alpha Stirling engine is light load application means low power engine, and this beta Stirling is high power engine means high load application. Is a use of, there is a two types of Stirling engine, alpha and beta Stirling. Means light, alpha Stirling engine is light load application means light application, and this beta is high load, this high application. It is a known as alpha and beta Stirling engine. You can see the diagram of this Stirling engine. This is alpha and beta Stirling engine. Then next point is component, main component of figure. You can see the Stirling engine diagram, simple net sketch, and how this work. You can see the heat source means you can this external heat, the fuel is burned, and this gas is expand and compression this hot cylinder, and then also the heat exchanger, heat snake connected to crank and flywheel. This piston and this gas, and this how it is this work of this piston. Okay, the main component, the next point is the main component of Stirling engine. Main part of Stirling engine, the first is cylinder. There is a two types. cylinder, hot wall cylinder and cold wall cylinder. Cold wall cylinder is the cooling of this gas is in cooling system. The gas is cool and the reuse the another cycle. Then first is cold wall cylinder means the cooling of this gas in cooling system to reuse the gas. And this hot cylinder means the external heat is so gas is compressed and expands. Means gas is burn and expand and compression for hot cylinder. Means both this cylinder is interconnected to hot to cold cylinder. It is a part of cylinder. Then piston. Piston is the same the engine. The electric total efficiency means total power is required means to electrical power provide to engine. It is a part of piston. Then gas. Gas is there is a gas is expansion and compression of this gas in cylinder. It is a part of gas. Then also the external heat source means the external heat source. The gas is compressed and expands. Means alpha Stirling engine cold to beta cold cylinder hot cylinder to cold cylinder means to beta and alpha Stirling to beta and it is a part of external heat source means gas is compressed and expands from this fuel. Then the cooling system means this cooling system the gas is cool. This alpha Stirling engine is cold wall cylinder to cold end of cylinder means the gas is cooling the system and reuse for another cycle. It is a part of cooling system. Then the crankshaft, the mechanical output through the piston to the connected to crankshaft to flywheel. Means the mechanical work is transferred from connect to crank to flywheel. It is a part of crankshaft and the flywheel. Flywheel means to store this energy to connect the crankshaft to store this engine to further use. It is a part of flywheel. It is a main part of this Stirling engine, cylinder, piston, gas, external heat source, then this cooling system, then crankshaft and flywheel. Okay, then next point is VCR engine, variable compression ratio engine. You can see the diagram of this VCR engine. Means internal combustion engine, this VCR, variable compression ratio is achieved by this increasing this efficiency to provide this power. Means the base example of this Honda Nissan. It is a VCR engine. In now our technology, you find out this Honda Nissan, this VCR engine is used. Okay. So first, second is how it is variable compression ratio is work. It is work. So first is VCR technology is to adjust the compression ratio of this IC engine, internal combustion engine, while the engine is in operation. Okay. Second is this is done the increasing this fuel efficiency while the under this varying load. Okay. Means the variable compression ratio is allow this volume of this piston at a day center to be changed. This higher load is required to low ratio to increasing this power. And this lower load required this higher ratio to increasing the efficiency to lower this fuel consumption. It is a part means so higher load required low ratio to increasing the power. And this lower load is required to high ratio to increasing the efficiency. This lower fuel consumption, it is a part of this VCR engine. The base used in Honda Nissan. It is a part of variable compression ratio. Means for automating, this need for to be done. As the engine is learning to respond to the load. And the driving demand, the 2019 is Infiniti QX50 is the first commercial available this car that is used as VCR engine, this variable compression ratio engine. Okay, so today we discussed about this non-conventional IC engine, the Stirling engine, the main component, how it is work of principle of Stirling engine, the main component part of the Stirling engine, then VCR engine. Okay? Thank you.